So then guys, today what I want to show you is the best MacBook money can buy in 2022, in my opinion. And what I mean by this, I mean the best bang for your buck, as it were. So this is the best performance and features in a MacBook for your money right now. Of course, the best MacBook out there is the MacBook Pro 16-inch, because it's got the biggest screen, you can get the M1 Max in it, you get the highest amount of RAM, the highest amount of storage, it's going to be the best. But like I said, I want to show you the best one that you can get right now. So I'm going to reveal what this MacBook is. So can I have a drum roll, please? And it's this. It's an M1 MacBook Air. And whatever you do, do not stop the video right now, because I want to explain to you why this MacBook Air is definitely the best one for your money right now, before switching over to looking up some MacBook Pros, the 14-inch and 16-inch, for example. And the best way, first of all, is let's have a look at the design of this MacBook Air. So the actual design of this MacBook Air was actually revealed in 2018 as the third generation MacBook design. On it, you've got things like a Retina display. You've also got the fantastic new Magic Keyboard, which was absolutely brilliant. And you've also got that Force trackpad as well, with those sort of haptic feedbacks inside. It was brilliant to use. And also, it's really, really large. Other features on this MacBook Air is you've also got two USB ports on it, or USB-C ports. And on that, it allows you to charge your MacBook. And also, you can use those Thunderbolt ports inside those USB-C, what are Thunderbolt 4 or USB 4. Now, first of all, I know what you're going to say, that isn't a lot of ports actually on this MacBook Air, but in all things considering, I know you've got the 14-inch and 16-inch MacBook Pros, will give you that SD card slot, an extra USB-C port, and also give you that HDMI port, but you can always buy yourself one of these, and it's a dongle. And I know they don't look the best hanging off this, but for what, like, I'm going to show in a minute, the price of this MacBook Air and buying one of these is far cheaper than buying yourself the cheapest 14-inch MacBook Pro out there just to get those couple more ports. You're better off buying this for, say, about $30, £25 or so. It's far, far better. Something else what makes this MacBook absolutely remarkable is got to be that chip underneath inside it. So the chip inside this is the M1 chip. Now the M1 chip, I'm going to show you some performance benchmarks in a second, is absolutely unbelievable. No matter what you throw at it as daily tasks, it can hack through it no problems. It doesn't care at all. So much so that Apple decided that because of daily tasks are going to be a breeze on this MacBook, they didn't even put a fan in it, because they knew that the chip wouldn't get overheated and it would be able to cope with kind of your daily kind of work. And some of those works I can also shout out there is including doing some photo editing or some video editing with some 4K video. I want to show you some benchmarking on in a minute to show how good this MacBook Air is. But it is truly a remarkable device, and it still does look absolutely beautiful in 2022, and it's super, super thin. In fact, look at my finger next to it here. That is how thin this MacBook Air is. It is absolutely amazing. Something else what is amazing about this MacBook Air is to do with its battery life. This MacBook Air, you can get up to 17 hours of battery out of it. And that 14-inch MacBook Pro, you can get up to 18 hours. And to be honest, it's very, very similar. But if that fan did kick in that 14-inch MacBook Pro, for example, probably the battery would be worse than this MacBook Air that you're seeing right here. So to be honest, it swings around them as they're almost neck and neck. And something else what makes this MacBook absolutely remarkable is got to do with its actual charger. The charger you actually get in the box is only a 30-watt charger. You heard me right, 30 watts. That's because the M1 chip is so efficient. Right now, I'm sure there's phones out there, and I'm sure that some of those Android ones, they come with a 45-watt, or they also come with, for example, like a 100-watt charger inside the box to get, you know, your phone charged up within, say, half an hour. Well, the 30-watt charger for this one can charge my MacBook Air that I have right here from about 3% battery all the way up to about 93, 95% in just over 2 hours. Now that is, you know, four times as long as 30 minutes, but you've got to remember the batteries inside this are way bigger than what you get inside a traditional mobile phone or smartphone. So yeah, it is really, really amazing. But I know what you're here for. You're probably wondering why I'm banging on about this MacBook Air and why you should definitely get it, and I've not even shown you how good it is in performance. Well, let me show you why it's so good in performance. And the best way to do that is to show you a chart with this MacBook Air, the 14-inch MacBook Pro, the 8-core version with the 14-core GPU, and also I'm going to compare the 16-inch MacBook Pro with the Intel i9 inside it, the last generation MacBook Pro with a dedicated graphics card. Well, let's have a look at some charts. Well, first of all, let's start with some Geekbench scoring, and let's first of all start with the single core score. And at the very bottom, you can see that 16-inch MacBook Pro with the i9, it was an 8-core processor, and it got really, really hot. But just above that, you've got the MacBook Air, and inside that, you've got that M1 chipset. And that M1 chipset in single core performance is 36% more efficient, which is absolutely amazing. And just above that, you also have the MacBook Pro 14-inch, the 8-core version, and the single core score is only 2%. To be honest, if you did it in a different environment, if I did another check again, probably the MacBook Air could even possibly overtake that 14-inch MacBook Pro. They're basically neck and neck. There is no difference there in single core. But moving on to multi-core, this is where things change a bit. Again, at the bottom, you've got the 16-inch MacBook Pro, and then above that, you've got the MacBook Air, and the MacBook Air is actually faster than the 16-inch MacBook Pro by 8%, what's absolutely amazing. The MacBook Air right now starts out at $1,000, whereas this MacBook Pro started out at about $3,200 or $3,500, I can't remember the exact amount, but you get your idea, over 3 times more in cost just 2 years ago. What's absolutely amazing that the MacBook Air can give you this performance for this kind of price right now. It's absolutely truly remarkable. And then the thing I think is even more interesting is the multi-core of the M1 MacBook Pro, the 14-inch one. And you can see here with this, you actually get an increase of 22%. And to be honest, that's not even a quarter more. That's just only, you know, it's just 22%. It's not going to make a huge difference. Yet that MacBook Pro costs $2,000. It starts at over $2,000. So it's more in money. And yeah, you can get the M1 MacBook Air and it costs far less. And it's absolutely amazing for that. Have a look at this Cinebench score next of all. 16-inch MacBook Pro at the top this time, that Intel i9 one, comparing it to the M1, you actually get a 36% increase in speed, which is truly amazing. And then with the 14-inch MacBook Pro, 1%, hardly anything, not even worth talking about, it's the same basically. But that's a 36% increase. And like I said on the last one, I think we had like 32% increase. You get the idea, it's in the 30s, it's a third more faster, this M1 chipset to that Intel MacBook Pro. But then looking at the multi-core for Cinebench, the 16-inch MacBook Pro, the Intel i9, is actually slightly faster by 6% compared to the M1 chipset. But then if you compared the M1 chipset to the M1 Pro with that 8 cores inside it, the MacBook Pro, then basically you can see there is a bit of a difference here. You actually get a 22% increase again, but still that's very similar to what we got on Geekbench. Again, not even a quarter more performance. So you can see why I'm banging on saying the MacBook Air is absolutely amazing. And I want to show you this again in doing Final Cut Pro. So what I did was I fired up Final Cut Pro and I exported a video, what was a 10-bit 4K video, and it was 15 minutes long, and look at the speeds, how long it took to export. In reverse order, we've got the MacBook Pro i9, it took 7 minutes 19 seconds to export. What's quite fair, to be honest, in 2022, that's okay. But I will say that MacBook Pro was super hot, the fans were whirring, and it was really going for it to export it. Then we have the MacBook Air next of all. Remember, there's no fan inside this, and it wasn't getting hot at all. It got a bit warm, you know, it was, you could put your finger on it, you could rest your hands on it. It was not boiling hot, but yet it exported this video in 6 minutes, 11 seconds. And then afterwards, you do have the M1 14-inch MacBook Pro, that 8-core version, and it exported the video in 5 minutes, 34 seconds. And to be deadly honest, there isn't much in it between that MacBook Air and also that MacBook Pro 14-inch with the M1 Pro 8-core. We're talking like about 30, just over 30 seconds difference to export it. Yeah, there's a $1,000 price difference between these MacBooks. And that is absolutely incredible when you really think about it. Something else what is incredible is what's happening on this channel right now. And that is I'm doing a giveaway for this. It's for an iPhone 13 Pro Max, a silver white 256GB model. And I'm doing an international giveaway of this iPhone. And if you want to be in a chance to get your hands on this iPhone 13 Pro Max, all I'd love to know from you guys is put down in the comments below what Apple gear, what technology gear you're planning to buy in 2022. And when we get over 350,000 subscribers, I'm going to be announcing who the winner is, and I'll be making a video about that. But if you're brand new here and you've never seen a video of mine, make sure you subscribe to the channel and also hit that notification bell, because you'll want to get a notification of when that video comes comes out. So make sure you do that right now. Now, something else I just do want to quickly mention, there are some scammers, there are some spammers, some of them are impersonating me, saying to Telegram you, to WhatsApp you. This is not me. Ignore them. Like I said, I will be making a video when we get over 350,000 subscribers, not before. I will not be telling you you are a winner until at least that stage. So ignore them or report them. With that out of the way, let's talk a little bit more about the MacBook Air, and I'm just going to go and grab it. So, I've talked about the actual performance, I've talked about the design and why I think it's absolutely amazing. Next of all, I want to talk about the price. Now the price, like I've said in my performance sort of geek benches and all of those sort of bits and pieces, I said it started at $1,000. But the thing is, you can actually pick up these MacBook Airs for far less if you do shop around. In fact, recently I made a video showing how you can get an M1 MacBook Pro or an M1 MacBook Air for far less, for basically 40% off if you buy it second hand. And to be honest, this is exactly what I've got here. I got this MacBook Air with an 8 counter on the cycle of the battery, and I also got still 3 months warranty or so inside this MacBook Air right now. So it's absolutely incredible that I have got this, and I managed to get this for £580, was basically 42% off the original price new. But if you do want to get it new, you can still get some good deals out there. I just went onto Amazon just to have a look right now, and I can see you can get 11% off the MacBook Air. And like I said, if you shop around, you might get some emails coming in if you signed up to some tech sort of people, and you can probably get this MacBook Air for even less than that. You can potentially get up to probably 20% off this MacBook Air brand new, and it is definitely worth it compared to the likes of, say, the 13-inch MacBook Pro, because with that, all you're getting over this MacBook Air is a touch bar, what's kind of being faded away. It was a gimmick, and even Apple are recognizing it needs to disappear. And also at the same time, you get a fan inside it, what could actually probably drain the battery a little bit more if you were using that fan quite often. But really, that is it, the difference between the MacBook Air and also the MacBook Pro. You're basically paying for that touch bar and basically for that fan inside it. The ports are the same, everything else is the same. And to be honest, the MacBook Air is also thinner and lighter, what I definitely do prefer. The other thing as well is that the 14-inch MacBook Pro, yes, it costs $1,000 more, but with that, main things you're getting is that M1 Pro chipset, was only slightly more faster, as you've seen in the performance. You do get the mini LED display, you do get a larger display as well, but in the grand scheme of it, for $1,000 more, or even, like I said, even if you manage to get 20% off one of these brand new, I can't really justify it. And as you can see by the Geekbench scores and all of those Cinebench scores and everything else like that, you can see that the MacBook Air is definitely a worthy buy in 2022. Now, one thing I do want to just chip in there is that a lot of you are saying, well, Matt, there's no point getting this MacBook Air because we've got the M2 MacBook Airs and M2 MacBook Pro possibly coming out in 2022. But all I will say to that is definitely with the MacBook Air, it's going to be a redesigned model. And when Apple like to make a redesigned model, that does mean the price will go up. So I personally believe that the new MacBook Air will not cost $1,000 US. I think it will cost more than that because of the redesign. And yet, probably most likely that M2 chipset inside the MacBook Air will probably only be between about 10 to 25% more faster. So a maximum of quarter faster. And I don't think it'll even do that. It's not often that happens. So again, this MacBook Air is definitely worth getting, the M1, definitely in 2022, if you want the best value for money with performance. So I would definitely look at getting into it because it is such a good MacBook. Well guys, with that out of the way, it's time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please also hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I will see you really soon. Bye bye.